Welcome everyone to episode 200 of Just Joshing. I am your host, Joshua Pentoloresco. I write stuff in podcast too. Today we're going to do something a little different today. I've been debating about how to do this particular episode because it's kind of special. I did 200 episodes, and it's been a crazy couple weeks of milestones for this podcast, or a month, I should say, because a month ago this podcast turned 3 years old. 2 weeks later, it went on Aurora. And 3 weeks later, a week after that, we're at my 200th episode. So, I mean, I've been thinking about how to do this and doing this right. There's a lot of things I want to talk about the future, and there's a lot of things I want to talk about now. So, I don't know, maybe I'll do most of that in episode 201. I kind of feel like this should be something a little different than what I normally do. So that's what I'm going to do. I think I'm going to make episode 201. There's going to be a lot of information at the end. But I want to just say here before we get into the board game, because I might have been working on a board game for a little bit. And this is kind of a test run featuring some really cool guests. And I won't spoil it. I'll let them tell who they are in the episode. But I kind of want to do this. Thank you to every guest. Thank you to every individual who has been on my show. Thank you to every listener. Thank you to the Canadian Science Fiction Fantasy Association. Thank you to everyone who has believed in and supported me. I appreciate it very much. I wouldn't have made it to 200 without you guys. And yeah, I appreciate it. I appreciate all of it. Yeah, I think that's good. I think I'm happy with that. So thank you. And I promise the next 100 will be just as fun. Who knows where we'll go from here. All right, let's get on with the show. So, I am live. I am with two amazing women. Introduce yourselves.
Hi, I'm Eddie Louise. I'm the head writer for the podcast, The Tales of Sage and Savant. I'm also a novelist and a ghost writer, which means I write other people's stories as well.
Yes.
And I'm from Southern California.
Awesome. And you?
Stacey Miller. I am a professional people person, I guess, at this point. I don't really know what else I do with my free time, but I'm currently working on a novel. I'm hoping to get into the literary world professionally.
Yes.
That's kind of my goal.
Okay. So I'm going to explain this. This was an accident.
Okay.
So what happened was I was asked a year ago by Colleen Anderson to do an epic poem about Lewis Carroll.
Okay.
I had no idea what I was doing until I met a girl with a golden tattoo, and then it occurred to me to do a mashup of Greek mythology and Alice in Wonderland, where
right.
Alice is Pandora. Now,
right.
I've done epic poetry before. I did an illustrated guide. I didn't want to do the same thing twice, but this was a fantasy world.
Fantastic.
Right, right. So I'm like, you know what I'll do? Because this is Alice in Wonderland. I'm going to do a board game map. Snakes and Ladders style.
I like it.
Right? And then when it didn't crystallize in my head, right, how do you play this board game, the rules came in. So this is what we're going to do while we talk. So
Okay. The
objective of the game is to catch the Queen of Hearts.
All right.
Now, in order to do that, so if she gets to here, we lose.
Okay.
So we had to roll dice. So she gets a two-turn. Oh, speaking of which.
Yeah. Oh, if we're going to roll the dice, we might actually need to have the dice on the table, right?
Yeah, exactly.
You know.
Yeah, so.
Details.
this is a combination of Snakes and Ladders, board games, and Clue. Now, this is what this is. So we have to acquire items to defeat the queen. Now, here's the bad news. I left the items at home. But basically what I'm going to do, make this a little easier, grab me some 3 black pawns. Because there were 3 of us playing. So, I'm going to let you choose. Alice, the black cat, or Medusa?
Ooh, that's a hard one for me.
Yeah, I know. They're all cool. And they all have they have unique abilities, each and every one of them.
Alice is too easily led. Black cat or Medusa? Black cat or... You know, Medusa has my heart.
Yep,
I'm sorry.
That's what I would have picked.
So, black cat or Alice?
I'm a cat.
Okay, you're the cat. You're the bishop. That means I'm Alice. It's all good.
Right.
So the queen...
We believe in gender bending.
Yeah, no, I'm totally cool with this. So the queen gets a two-turn head start because she's the evil queen.
Okay.
So 3 pawns. So what we're going to do is, our objective is we need to defeat these three.
Okay.
If we beat those three, we take that pawn. If we beat those three, we get what I call Wonderland items. And each one's unique.
If you get it, you get the ability when you walk with the queen to roll your dice three times, and you keep the best roll.
Okay.
If you win, you can manipulate, since you're the black cat, you get to manipulate one die perfectly while rolling three die. So you get to actually manipulate two.
So two are random and one is my choice.
One is your choice. On the other hand, I don't get any of those abilities. However, the queen, my target, because I'm Alice, the queen is 11. Your targets are 13. The queen, however, again, you get a plus one bonus on your dice. You also get a plus one bonus on your dice. So if you roll sixes, you actually have sevens.
Okay.
You can beat the queen. So, but you gotta weaken the queen. If you fight the queen at any point without an item, you can't beat her. That's okay. Just the way it goes. Make sense so
sure,
far?
She's queen, sure. Yeah.
Miss Elaine, how you doing?
Hi.
Yes?
Yeah.
Yeah. Come on in.
Don't move this chair?
Yeah.
Is this holding the board flag?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, this is the board game. Yeah, it's cool. So, queen rolls first. Now, here's the thing. Queen is immune to all... will not fight a monster on the board.
Okay.
But all these little dots you see here are portals.
Okay.
They move every time a seven is rolled.
Okay.
The portals?
So is the portal from green to green and orange to orange?
Yeah. It just makes it really simple, right? Uh-huh. Really, really yep. Simple for you. So they move, and they move up on the board as it goes. They get to 100... they go all the way back down to 1, 2, 3. They just keep constantly moving.
Okay.
And any monster or person caught in portal gets sucked in with the portal.
Okay.
So it's a kind of...
So you don't want portals. So
you do and you don't. Sometimes you do, sometimes you don't.
You want to be able to use them to move yourself, I'm assuming?
Yes.
But you don't want to be on a portal when it moves because you have to go wherever it goes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. And the queen does get dragged along with
I've
them.
Yeah, I've played with your tricky sorts before.
Yeah. So let's roll.
I recognize that.
The first roll is 9. So the queen goes 1, she gets in the second roll. And then that's it. And then it's the chase. No matter how... the beautiful thing about the way I built this, no matter how far ahead the queen may get, you can still always catch her.
Yeah. 10.
No portals.
All the way up to 19. 19. All
right, so I'm gonna let Medusa go first.
Okay.
And we're gonna go around. So if you roll a 7, let me know. 6. You fight a monster. Hey. So all you gotta do is roll a 3 and you beat him.
Okay.
You beat him.
No problem.
So you get. Oh, hold on. Did I get this?
And does the monster leave the board?
The monster leaves the board. You defeat the monster, and this is for you.
Fantastic.
You get lucky dice.
Yeah, change one die to desired outcome, and then discard. Nice.
Yes. So you get little items as you go. Now, I didn't make a ton of these, so this is the flaw in this game, but...
So, Elaine has joined us. Do we have someone who can...
Do you want to be Alice, Elaine? Okay, do you want me to roll for you?
Oh, I can roll.
You can roll? Okay. 4.
Ooh.
It's okay. No, by the way, this is gone. Pawn's gone.
Okay.
You killed him. So, oh wait, wrong order. You're Medusa. Ah. The black cat, however, can go. So, in my story, the cat is in Alice's head. 7. So, we're going to do the top one or the most right one is the number of places the portals move. So, before anything else happens, the portals move. 6. 6. 50.
So they go up by 6?
They go up by 6 because that's the most topmost die. I think that's right. And 49. Did any monsters get hit by any of the things that move?
No. That one's the only one that hasn't moved yet.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so done. So now, you're 7. So she's at 19. So there you go. And that's it. And then now it's the queen's turn. The queen is a non-player character. So where's the other die? Ah. Also, when the queen rolls a 7, it's she too. Well,
got to set it up on here.
I'm gonna put it right here.
Yeah,
okay. On the board.
Yeah, hold the corner.
Might as well. 6.
The great thing about playtesting new games is that you're using uneven pieces and boards that roll up and stuff like that.
Yeah. That's what it's like when I'm playing regular board games because I lose everything.
But it also does give you that idea of where the stress points are on your board.
Exactly.
And then so when you actually build a permanent board, you're accounting for those things.
Yes.
That's fantastic. Yeah. So.
No, this is why you test.
Medusa rolls a 5.
So 11. Okay. Miss Elaine.
Butt on the board, nothing there to worry about.
Yes.
Alice
ten.
Rolls
10.
Go, Alice.
I see
rolling
mammals.
That's
yeah,
right.
She went right past me.
No, I know. I know.
It's my turn, right?
Yeah, it's your turn, totally.
Yeah, you just missed the monster.
It's time for me as well.
So you guys are going.
Yeah, we're missing the monsters, too. That's good.
Yes.
We'll just skip right past those monsters.
Right.
You don't want to skip the ones with the blocks, though. So,
yeah, that's true. We need to get the black ones.
Yeah, the black ones are... So each one of... So you may miss this. To fight the queen, you need a treasure to fight the queen.
And that's these.
Now, you guys can... Now, here's the cool thing about this one. You can work together with the queen. So you can give them... Each of you have that... Let's say you have a Wonderland item.
Yeah.
You can give it to her, and it's her Wonderland item.
Fantastic.
And so, right. So you can work together, depending on how the board state plays out.
Yeah.
Is it... So you rolled?
No, I just went here.
Queen. Six. Not a good roll for the queen, but she's still ahead. You want to keep up with her, that's the idea, right? So. Five.
Five.
You fight a monster.
Just passed.
Oh, you did just pass her.
Because I was down. Yeah,
11 to 16.
Yeah, okay, so. Miss Elaine.
Gosh, this is going.
Yeah, I know. Eight.
Do I okay? Doubles again. Devils again.
I know.
It's your day to go to the casino.
Yes.
I know.
Ten. You're doing really good too. 27. All right. So you don't want to miss the. You don't want to miss. And this is where I don't really have a set rule. You have to fight these monsters.
So if I roll higher than them, am I going to get trapped on that spot?
I haven't figured this out yet, so this is one of those things I need to figure out.
Well, that would make sense.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's like your roll, like, you know, it's kind of like Trivial Pursuit.
Yeah.
Where it's like no matter what you roll, if you end up on a triangle, you have to stop.
Yep,
yeah.
Fair enough. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so that makes sense.
Yeah.
So that way that you can't just avoid everything
and
dump it on someone else. You know, hey, you go fight the monsters and I'll just dump it on you.
10. Wow. So in the game I played previous to this, sevens were such a constant thing. And I picked seven. I picked seven for a very deliberate reason.
So, all right, 10.
16.
26 is on the monster.
Nope.
No,
it's our team.
There, 26 is there. It goes this way. So you're 16? 26.
Ah!
You, yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay. I missed that.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Miss Elaine, you roll.
So. Sorry, of course. No, I was rude and I didn't move the dice to the right side of the table.
26.
Okay.
So, your turn.
Hey, we're having a meeting, girl.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have a flask. So, you know, we can have a little drink.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
Yes.
We keep rolling.
Yeah, yep. Hey, there's things that make your journey easier, that's all I'm saying.
Wow, Queen had a bad roll. Three.
So
if you roll higher, you gotta fight that monster. It's seven.
Seven.
You're not quite there. 32. Alright, Miss Elaine.
So six.
Not quite.
We're avoiding the monster.
Yes. Yes. She's not.
Yeah.
No.
So I'm there now.
Your target is an eight. Your target's an eight. If, by the way, you do fail, you go back to 21. There's zones, so you don't ever completely lose. Ooh.
Not great.
Okay.
Yes, that's the way it goes.
So the color blocks create the zones, and that's the farthest back you go.
Yeah.
It's not like a save point.
Yeah, yeah.
It's
you're chasing something down, right? So.
Yeah.
I figure it'd be fair that way. Six. You missed the portal.
What happens when the queen lands on a monster? Nothing?
Nothing. Okay. She's immune to monsters. She's not immune to portals.
But if she lands on a portal, it takes her.
Yeah.
And that reminded me of one other question. What happens if you land on the upper portal? Does it take you back to the back portal?
Oh, yes,
right.
It does.
It makes
the
monster's part.
Yeah.
Yes.
I guess it, yeah.
Yes. 12. You get the... You
double. But I'm here, so I can't do that. So I have to try. Let's see if we can get that 8 on that monster.
Yes.
Okay. Talk to me, sweet baby. Give me those doubles again.
Yeah.
Got it.
Got it.
You got your item.
So, we got our first icon now. Yeah,
so you can fight the queen if you catch her. Now here's the thing. Mm-hmm. For the rest of the game, uh-huh. every monster you fight, you get three rolls, and you keep your highest. You can with just these two dice, and you get the plus one though only applies to the queen.
Okay.
All right. So you get three rolls for the rest of the game. However, at the same token, if you can also help a person, but if you do that, you miss your turn. Right. By giving the item away. So you won. Your turn. Okay.
And the other point that I just realized about skipping monsters is that when you do beat a monster, you get a special card.
Yes.
So skipping the monsters is also skipping the specials.
Yeah. Yes. You do have some. You were the queen.
No, she's Alice.
Yeah. The queen. So she's here. She's moved over here.
Yeah.
Yeah, here you are. So yeah, it's kind of, that's kind
of. Oh, I see. You're saying you're the chess piece, the queen, and I'm going, no, she's not the queen. She's Alice.
No.
You're screwed with my brain.
I am. So
I'm Alice too.
You are Alice. Alice is the black queen. So this, yes.
He was saying chess piece queen, and I'm thinking character queen, and my head exploded.
It's okay. So there's also a very deliberate design in the monsters, and also in like the colors. The Mad Hatter's the Black King.
Yeah.
She's the White Queen.
Right?
The next character piece I'm introducing is Jason. He's the White Knight.
Nice.
Is he just Jason?
As in Jason from the Greek myth.
Right,
yeah.
Jason and the Argonauts?
Yeah.
The Golden Fleece?
Yeah.
I don't know any mythology.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah,
it's totally
a mythological choice.
Yeah, Jason doesn't happen in space on
Yeah.
So this
zone here is John Carter of Mars.
Okay.
In the actual story, there is our world.
Yeah.
Oz.
Okay.
Mars.
Nice.
Wonderland graveyard.
Mm-hmm.
Primordial chaos.
Okay. I like that.
Yeah. They all tie together. So anyway, Queen's roll. Five. Oh, wow. So she's just quietly walking. This has been one way. Nine. Wait, you were 34.
34.
You're here.
Yeah.
You're actually gonna 43, get. You're gonna get ahead of the queen.
Oh!
You're ahead of the queen.
Nice.
Yes.
Yay for the portals.
Yes. Yay.
Yay for the portals. All right, queen, come up on me.
Queen rolls seven. You're gonna get sucked in.
No. The portals move first, and then that happens. There's movement. So she'll miss that portal.
I'm saying, like, if we roll a seven, this portal moves.
Yeah.
So no sevens, please.
No sevens.
Eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay, so you have to actually fight this.
Yeah.
Now this one can only be beat by prime numbers greater than five. So you have to roll seven.
Oh, there's so much math in this game, dude.
I know. It's
prime numbers, though.
Come on,
it's
like we think.
So make this really easy. 7 or 11.
Thank you. Just say
7 or 11. Yeah, 7 or 11. Roll it. Yeah, I know. Well, you're in the orange zone. The orange is a nasty zone. Red's a nastier zone, and this is the ultimate nasty zone.
Prime it.
Yeah, you're priming it. Go for it. Ooh.
Eight.
This is mean. But you only go back here.
Yeah, not too bad, actually.
Yeah. Because you lost. You lost the match, but you only go down to here. You never go below. Yeah, exactly. It's an eight.
Oh, I'm still way down there.
Oh, no, I meant, what
because,
was your left
because through? You'd gone back.
Oh, yeah. And it's okay.
I need it for the
match.
Yes, it does.
Does this game ever end?
You ran into an obstacle, so you went backwards. If you beat the obstacle, you keep going forwards. Right?
You just have to do math first.
Yeah, exactly. On that one. That one's
the
math
one. Yeah, the one big problem with me having that portal thing, though, is now I'm in front of...
You are, but that's...
Like, that's totally on you guys now, unless you bounce me back.
Or you can pass your item to them to help them win.
Yeah.
That's the other thing, too.
But I can't come back and fight these unless I get bounced back.
Yeah. Exactly.
And I'm in red, so I wouldn't bounce back to those anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. You're past all of them now.
Yeah.
Right. So...
But that works in your favor, too. If you get here, you get a cool bonus if you beat him. if you beat him. If the queen gets there, she takes her 3 turns to beat him. He's a boss, but a bonus boss. You don't actually have to fight him. Ooh, I rolled 7. And everything removes the space. Everything
moves. You're kidding.
Right.
No, she's not actually. She's going here. The portal just moves 1 space. She's not going to get sucked. But anyone that hits those portals, including monsters, like this one hit a like this one here, so this monster hit that. So this monster is going up to you.
Ah.
So that's a little chaos. Now this is an easy monster, but
Okay, so with the portals moving you, it moves when on the new space, not on the old space.
Yeah,
okay.
It moves and then moves.
Yeah.
Right? So it's a little bit more interesting that way. So So 7 for the queens.
Did we move the orange one?
I didn't move that one. No, that one didn't move. So she's here. Okay, go. First. She wants to be at... Ooh, she's...
7.
Another one. Yeah. And yoink.
And they go up 1?
If they go to 50, like 50, and then they go up. If they go to 100, they go all the way back down here, too. So the board always changes, ideally. So...
Okay. Where does this one need to go?
One. Up 1.
Yeah,
so that's
No, I moved myself.
Oh, okay.
She did, yeah.
Okay. 7, 4, okay. Done. Yeah. Yeah, okay. Yeah, so, Miss Elaine, you get to try again. Actually, it's still fun. However, I forgot to mention this last time, so I'll give you this opportunity. You can help Elaine.
Okay, how do I do that?
Yeah, she can help you. So here's what happened.
Can I give her my thing?
You can't give her that, the actual Wonderland item you got. You can give it to Elaine. So Alice's ability is she reduces the targets. That's right. So you get a little bit more variety in where you're going. You don't need 7-11 anymore. You just need to get below 7. Or 7, I should say. You got it. If she gives you the item.
If I give her the
item. Yeah. So
okay.
You have it. You have it now. You have 2. Yeah, you get 2. So near next turn, you can give it to her to help her, or you can give back. You should give 1 back to them. At least 1 of them. So
you can keep trading them around as
you need to, because you're working together.
I
want now. What? Yeah.
When the moment is right.
Yes.
When the need is great.
Roll. Yeah. 11. That's a nice roll. She's back on the board. You don't need rescuing. You got a Wonderland item now.
She's just teasing. When the need is great.
Okay. Queen. She got hit by... No, she just missed it.
So we always think that we'll be the person like Princess Leia who gently says... Help us, Obi-Wan Kenobi, you're our only hope.
Yes.
But in reality, most of us would be like, right?
Nice. Yes.
You know, that's me.
Yes.
I would probably just roll.
Oh, wow.
7. So, 86.
So you're getting close to it. This guy never moves. This guy does not get hit by portals either.
Nope, you're done with that now. Just a normal roll.
Normal rolls at this point for you.
6.
Ooh.
So, 51.
Not a big roll, not a big boost, but it's a boost nonetheless.
Oh, that's right, because she gets the Alice boost.
Yes. So you went up a little bit. You saved some, you got moves. Oh. They all have a special ability.
Nice catch.
8.
That was a complete off the table, like, ping pong moment.
Absolutely.
Queen sometimes Spirit. Podcasting, I wish that people could see because it's like the things that happen.
That was pretty awesome.
Yeah, it really was. That the reflexes,
yeah.
You know.
Usually I'm very clumsy, so I'm very pleased.
Actually, it's really cool. So I'm eventually going to go to a video. I want to do a Joe Rogan style thing with this podcast eventually. And when I get to that point,
7. 4.
That's number roll. So it's the right or it's the rightmost. If it ties, uppermost.
Okay.
So 4 spaces this time.
So all the portals move up 4.
Yeah. Oh, you got
uh-oh,
it.
Uh-oh, on monster.
Monster move, but so did she. Guess what? You're here.
But that one goes there. Where's the other orange one?
Elaine gets to fight it.
I'm 56. Elaine, sorry, we're dumping this on you again.
But you got abilities now.
Yeah.
You actually have two of them, which is interesting. Rolls against opponent. Oh, so this is Hercules. So here's the deal. In this matchup, it's highest roll. Hercules versus you. But here's the deal. You have two Wonderland items. I don't know how that would work in that set. With her, it would make total sense because you can boost.
Yeah.
You can manipulate die rolls.
Yeah.
Alice penalizes. So I don't know how that would work with Hercules.
Sorry. So Alice
lowers targets. But so I don't know how that would work here because this is just a high roll contest.
Well, wouldn't it just penalize Hercules' roll?
Right.
Yeah.
Then it just lowers his roll.
Yeah. You got so my her is minus one. You was normally.
Or you could do it like a
D&D
style sort of thing, where it's like you roll with advantage, right? So Alice gets to roll twice, take the best of her two, and Hercules only gets to roll once.
Yeah.
Okay. Fair enough. You roll twice. I'm gonna roll once as Hercules.
And you get to take your best.
You take your best roll, whatever it is. Four.
Not great. Let's see if we can't get a little higher. We're still on the doubles, though.
Oh,
great! What? What the heck?
Oh my
god. We're doing the doubles today.
Yeah.
Wow. So all you have to do is beat a four.
Yeah, I have to be a four. And
oh my god.
But the penalty is you go all the way back down to green.
Oh.
If Hercules beats you, because it's Hercules.
Oh.
Yeah,
he's a douche.
Yeah, he is.
Anyway. And he's a douche.
Anyway, yeah.
Hercules! Man!
I designed that monster to be a little bit evil.
Yeah, that's a lot evil, frankly.
Yes. Yes. It is.
That's a lot evil. Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
You still have your items, though, which is really weird. You'll beat anything. Eight. 24, we were? 82.
Oh, I'm getting close to the top.
You both are.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
That's okay. Each, and Queen. Where is Queen's roll?
Over here.
Where am I?
You're way at the back.
No, Alice is all the way back here, but the Queen of Hearts is up here.
When Hercules beats you,
11.
He knocks you all the way to green.
Ah.
That was just a Hercules thing. I'm sorry.
Hercules is evil.
Yeah.
Hercules, what are you doing?
Never trust a pretty boy.
Yeah, that's right.
Never trust a pretty boy. I'm telling you.
However, you can still help the team.
He knows what he's got.
Yes.
Right?
Marry a hot guy and he'll leave you.
Yep.
I was like, mommy, right?
That's good advice. And in my own case, nerds often turn into hot guys.
Oh, yes. Mine did. I married one.
Yeah, mine did too.
I went to the mall and I got him a haircut and now he's
cleaning
up.
Yeah. My husband has the mustaches.
I met your husband this morning.
Earlier, yeah.
Yeah, he was cool.
Oh, I would never bring out into something.
Nine.
Nice.
You're getting there. So this is what's going to happen. So you guys are going to have to strategize, because guess what? You cannot since you got there first, you cannot avoid him.
Yeah.
And she's got all the Wonderland items.
Yeah.
You might want them against him.
Yeah, and it's probably going to happen on my next roll.
Yeah. So you guys should... As you keep rolling, you guys love. You're near the top of the
wall.
But the thing is, it's your turn.
Yeah, but I'm almost thinking, Elaine, I hope you get a six.
12. Why couldn't you get that roll? Like
you got doubles.
Why couldn't you get that? That could be him. Why can't you get that roll?
Yeah, why can't you?
So.
Okay. Right. So Stacey's turn.
Yeah.
So that's a.
Six. Yeah. It's possible. So, if you beat the Mad Hatter, we get to endgame. Where if you guys beat him, since you're there before the Queen is, very nice how the portals helps you guys with that.
Okay.
So we all. So you guys, you said the Mad Hatter, who in my story is actually Kronos, the God of Time.
Okay. Sure.
Eight.
Have you ever read any of Jasper Ford's books?
Yes. I do. I read the first one. I read the first one. I loved it.
You read The Eye Affair, or?
I think that's the one I read, yeah.
That's the first one in the Thursday Next series. He has other series, too.
Thursday Next is my hero.
Oh my God,
and Lost in
so
a Good Book.
I love
and
her so much.
That
yes.
concept.
My favorite
if you
one
haven't,
was,
if you haven't read them, the concept
you
is that there's a detective agency whose job is to keep the characters from one book away from infecting the other books. And there are rogue characters that move from book to book. And Thursday next is a detective trying to stop them.
It's based off the premise that there's this whole other world where all the characters in the books are actors. So when you're reading a book, they like come out and perform it for you. And when you're not reading it, they like go off and live a life.
They have their only life. Yeah, yeah. But the thing is that you don't want Jack the Ripper skipping into Jane Eyre. And Thursday next is so brilliant.
Oh my god,
and,
oh, I love those books. Anything about her dad.
I knew we had a lot in common when we chatted.
The reason I chose the Mad Hatter, because Mad Hatter, all he does is kill time. I thought that is perfect.
Yeah.
Right, it's a perfect thing.
And oh my god, who would win in the boss battle, the Mad Hatter or Doctor Who? One controls time, one kills time.
So.
Well, I feel like the Mad Hatter, because the Doctor is all like, oh, don't kill people, I'm altruistic.
Well, no, it depends.
I think the Mad Hatter, partially because
the Doctor would just be like, I'm gonna kill you, and he'd be like, oh.
The Doctor's used to being the only madman in the room.
Yes.
No, that's not true.
And
he hangs out with all sorts of madmen all the time.
But I think this is what it comes down to, which Mad Hatter is dealing with. Because Mad Hatter has his somber moments.
Yeah.
He has his manic moments.
Yeah.
Somber Mad Hatter doesn't have a chance against the Doctor.
And then also which Doctor.
Yeah.
Because whichever Doctor you're dealing with, one of them would probably just,
Okay, so we've got this complicated thing going on here because we've only taken two of the special items.
So
the third one is back here, stuck back here, where the only person who could even get to it at all is Alice, but she's 3-4 turns away.
Yeah, so
I'm at the one turn to the Mad Hatter.
So here's the deal. She can give you items. She can give both of you items since you're already at the top.
Right.
This is where you can work together.
And Right,
and this is where
but she can't give both of them to me, correct?
No, correct.
Can we finish the game without killing this monster?
Yes, you can, because you actually have Wonderland items.
We just can't fight the queen without that monster, but the queen's behind us.
So no, so the Mad Hatter has an interesting little bonus. If you beat the Mad Hatter, you get another Wonderland item. Now, normally that person would have two, but that would be three in total for this board.
Ah, so then you could fight the queen. Okay.
Yes.
Might I please, darling Elaine, have one of the fantastic items? Help! Help! Now's my turn. Okay, you remember that flask with that fine Scottish whiskey? I mean, come on.
I think you're
a drinking buddy here. Come on.
Okay. This is where you guys are working together. Yeah. This is the thing, right? And this does happen.
Josh has to remind you that you're supposed to be nice.
Yes. Now, it's supposed to be, but otherwise the queen will eventually get to the end of the board and she'll win. It's your choice.
Yeah.
You help, because you're so behind and the odds are, it is entirely possible you might get to skip all the way here. It is possible. However, at this point in time, they most likely have the best chance of beating the Mad Hatter, who's straight up a target of 12. However, she rolls 3 times with a plus 1.
She holds it out. Wait. I have one more question. Wait.
What's the question? But that's what it comes down to.
No, I'm giving away my.
You have another one.
You're working together. You're working together. So
bye.
Yeah. But here's the deal.
Okay.
When I introduce Jason to this story.
Okay, I'm establishing a board rule. If there's a bag of holding in this game, we probably better not let Elaine have control of the bag of holding.
Yeah, it's all right. Yes. Yes.
A bag of holding. Do you play D&D? A bag of holding is a magical bag that can hold anything you put it in. Normally thieves use it for treasure, which is fantastic. But the problem is it's just a normal size bag. It's not big. So it's easy to steal with. So you do not give the bag of holding to untrustworthy people.
Yeah. Okay.
That's what I was sensing. That's what I was getting here. Okay, so I rolled a 4. What's up with that? I'm a 99.
Nice.
Just missed the portal. I was almost right back here with you.
So here's the deal. No matter what, next turn, you fight
No matter what, next turn.
Unless she does.
Yeah.
Which is possible.
Yeah.
So.
Sorry. Being the worst right now.
Yeah.
Work stuff that I don't want to deal with. So I'm responding. I don't know. Leave me alone.
Yeah, okay. Cool. So, Miss Elaine, there is a chance she fights the Mad Hatter. Do you want to help her?
Well, Elaine gets to go first. She gets her turn. Yeah, that was just mine.
Yeah.
So roll.
Six. So, 18. Okay.
It would have to be
a 12, and that's rare.
Oh.
Seven.
Portals move. That one's there.
How many? Sorry?
Six minus rightmost. Rightmost.
Eight.
So, that
one. Don't make me count, man.
I'm not making you count. I'm not making you count. 460. And that one moves as well. Nothing, no one, but no one.
So 44.
Yeah.
It goes to 44. Go.
Yeah.
That's what I was looking for.
Yeah. So there you go.
Looking
so,
at upside down. It's
yeah,
like,
yeah. Yeah. No. No. So it's even. It's yeah. Like, mm-hmm. So it's seven. So you are here.
Yes.
So next turn, no matter. Okay, you get the first crack at this.
But yeah.
So you got one land on. So your ability is plus one bonus, three rolls.
Right, and then I've got my special card that I won for finding the thing, which allows me to change a die roll.
Yes, it does.
So
you basically,
you like
I can change one die.
You have four.
So I got three rolls, but I've got a change of one die.
Yes. So that's your special ability.
Okay.
So you ready to fight the Mad Hatter?
So no, because the Queen still has to go.
Yeah.
Yeah. Queen, yeah, she does have to go. Yes. Where?
I mean, I'm on fight any time.
Yeah.
We're good.
Okay, thank you.
She's at 87. Okay, that's it.
Okay. So obviously.
Yeah, you're fighting.
I'm 10. I'm fighting it. There's no question.
Yeah.
Okay, so three rolls with the possibility to change one die. So if I roll a single six, I'm changing the other die to six.
That's how it works. You have a 50-50 chance.
Oh, God. So just.
Sorry, Elaine.
You destroyed die, so I'm gonna give you another die.
Okay,
so
we roll where it went.
Yeah.
I'll find it.
Ah!
How did you do that?
Okay.
Well, you got it.
Okay.
You beat the Hatter.
So, changing that one. I got it.
So here's the deal. You get to fight the Queen now.
Oh, lucky me!
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
So you beat the Mad Hatter. So he was super hard because he's immune to everything. But but you got bonuses. So.
Okay, but.
So now the Queen.
Uh huh.
Now you get to fight the Queen. So the Queen's target is 13. So you do need another six. The lucky die is gone.
Oh, should it? Yeah, that was not me being very smart then, was it?
Actually, no, it's fine. So basically.
You still have your three rolls.
You get three rolls, three cracks, three shots. So.
But the thing is, three rolls to get to 13 is not going to happen when my total max is 12.
Yeah, but you get a plus one bonus on your sixes.
And then I've got,
that's why you can fight the points.
Okay. So.
Keep going.
Seven is not enough.
One, you got one.
Oh. So do I hold that one and then
you
just
can choose, you can choose
do that
to,
like
yeah,
that way?
Yeah.
So that's a seven for you now, right?
Yeah, it's seven. You need to get a five.
Yeah, plus
yeah.
One.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You get a five or a six. Queen wins.
Queen wins.
She just kills all of them?
No. She beats
kills
you.
Me, right?
Yeah.
Right, so I'm off. So now it's on you guys. Sorry.
So there's no more board movements because you've already beaten Chrono. So it's just fighting with the Queen. So you guys can work together to do it.
So you guys decide to fight the Queen. And this, since I died, does this stay with me or
no,
can it pass back over?
No, you can pass. You're working together.
Right, okay, so that each of you have a special.
Actually, get three specials, so, because you beat the Hatter.
Oh, that's right.
Okay, so what do we need to do?
Your target number to beat the Queen is 11. You get a plus one bonus on your dice. Oh, no, you're the cat, right? That's hers. Yours is, you can manipulate any die roll.
Right.
And one die is automatically manipulated no matter what. You get to roll twice. She rolls three times because she's the warrior of the group.
Got it.
Right? And your target is just 11.
And what do these do for us?
These are the one land items. They reduce, when the Queen starts the game, her number is plus 13, plus everything.
So the fact that you have two is what brought her down to 11.
Yeah. It's basically a penalty, it knocks her penalty down so you can fight it.
Yeah, if we'd had that one too, it would have brought her down to 10, make it a little easier. Yeah, I can see why making sure you fight all the,
But that's what makes
on the way through.
Yeah. Strategy to skip them.
No, not the three. But that's okay. It's one of those things, right? And I'm learning as much as you guys are. So.
Playtesting. Playtesting is amazing how it teaches you what works and what doesn't. Okay.
So, do you want to give a try first, or do you want her to try first?
Okay, so I get two rolls.
You get two rolls. One roll, you can play
any.
Yeah.
Can I hold a die for my first roll and then roll my second one just by itself?
Yeah. So that's six right there. That's not terrible. You have plus one, so that's six.
Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna keep it. I'm gonna spend all this money. Yes!
You win.
Yes!
You guys won.
Rocks. So long, queen!
You beat the queen of hearts. You guys won. So,
Great. This
is my guess. Feedback. How was it?
Overall, I really like it. I think that the placement of the monsters, clustering them all to the center of the board, probably made it more easy for us to skip them.
Yeah.
Because of the way the rolls fell, so I might consider.
It's okay. I'm lying.
Yeah, for me, if that was something, I think spreading the monsters out a little more, because since the portal took me completely out of the middle of the board, it was just past them all. And that's the thing.
Yeah.
So I would do some thinking about the portal placement things. I really like the portals.
Yeah.
And I like the fact that the portals move to different places.
The thing about that too is that every time you play, it changes the game.
Yeah.
It changes your strategy.
And I like that a lot. And I like the combination with the Mad Hatter and the Queen.
Yeah.
The Mad Hatter's a boss, but that's not the central fight. The central fight still comes back to the Queen.
Yeah.
I like that a lot.
Yes.
And that's really interesting. So
it fits the story very well too.
Yeah.
I think it does need a few more structures around some of the gameplay with the fighting.
Yeah.
You know, like the specificities of like how much power the roll has, how much power that monster has, because some of it's sort of like, oh, in this scenario, what happened? You know what I mean? Like, so it just maybe needs a little more structure in the event of type of things.
And I might add, like, a monster randomizer of some sort. So, like, maybe in each section, there's a place that's marked, and just a random number that's marked in each section, which if somebody lands on that, a new monster hits the board.
Oh, I like that.
I do like that.
You know, because then one of the things that I love about the
mystery.
Yeah, one of the things that both mythology and the Wonderland story have in common is those random encounters.
Yes.
You know, and if you did that in each section, you had a pre-planned random encounter where you draw the card out of the thing and you add it to, and maybe it's, you know, even a randomizer of where it goes on the board or something, but that would be fun to kind of have it, because then the board would always be changing, which means that
your
strategy
would like
need
the first
to
time I played
too.
This, I had 8 portals on the board. That was a little too much.
That was probably too much.
It was a little too much. 6 feels right.
Yeah.
6 feels right.
Which is a good amount because we hit them.
Yeah.
But they weren't constantly throwing us off.
Yes. Yeah. Which is good. So. Miss Elaine, do you have anything? Did you like the game? If you don't like the game, that's fine too.
I got confused. But I like the portals.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's what I really love.
Yeah.
You also miss a lot of the explanation at the beginning too though.
Yeah.
So that probably would have helped if you would have heard it in
your comments. No, fair enough.
I didn't think that's
Well, thank you. So, I'm gonna actually add more. I'm gonna add more treasures to the game too, because it just because I want. I know because the reason. Oh, so that's
are you
cool.
Are you the person? Oh, fantastic.
Oh. Okay.
Oh, fantastic.
So it'd be a mess.
Yeah.
We'll talk in a few months. Right now, right now, this is all about getting the mechanics down right.
Yeah.
That's why it's hodgepodge. Totally hodgepodge.
Yeah.
Right, so.
Yeah, but that's what you have to do, is you get your mechanics right, and then you can decide things like, what do the playing pieces look like?
Yeah, so,
you know,
I chose 7 for a very deliberate reason.
And I think, and this is a thing of just when the game is built itself, but having a card with each piece, so it's like, if I'm Alice, I have a little card that tells me all my abilities.
Which I will do, absolutely.
Yeah.
There's definitely going to be a card game component to this game, where like the reason there are cards here is just for that, remind that of that.
One other thing that I'm kind of seeing that's a possibility here that you may or may not have thought about, I think you've got a two-sided game here.
I have.
I think you play it as a cooperative game if you're the players against the Queen and the Mad Hatter. But then it could be a competitive game if you are the Mad Hatter and the Queen, and
I mentioned this earlier. I'm going to bring back this part. I want you to know something. The enemies are white. Allies are white. My next board game piece is a white knight. Why would I choose a white knight? He's not on your team. He might work with you on some things.
Yeah.
But he might not work with you. For example, it's Jason. Now, if you know the story of Jason,
you already gone rogue, you know.
No, I've already been thinking about this. You have Medusa. and you have Jason, they don't get along.
Yeah.
Right? And so the idea is I'm going to introduce eventually, also, you might also have noticed this, there's no white king. There's a deliberate reason for that right now.
Yeah.
Right? Right? So the idea behind this is I'm going to release it as a book slash board game combo. The base game is going to be a cooperative game. I think that's the right way to start.
Yeah.
Then as you release new books, you release new expansions, new monsters, and new objectives. So eventually, Alice is going to have her own objectives. Like Matt, the black cat, or the Cheshire cat, is going to have his own objectives, right?
Yeah.
Medusa is going to have hers, right? And Jason's going to have his. And I have at least, and I have two other characters in my head that I might, one as a player, and then, of course, because this is, because I'm just evil that way, whoever the mysterious white king is going to cause a different thing. But that's down the road. I want to get the base game. I've learned this from writing stories.
Yeah.
You build the structure, then you play the cool thing. No, but there is I've thought about this. There is a competitive aspect to this game. Which if you decide to solo against the queen, that's a lot harder. You have to beat everybody else to get the items required to lower the bounty. And that's harder, so. But anyway. Yeah.
But anyway, it's all good. And it's a good length of time.
Yeah.
For gameplay. Like, it didn't drag, but it wasn't over in a second either.
Yeah.
Yeah, that
was, that was what I was going for. So, this is what we're going to do. First off, I'm glad you liked it, Miss Elaine. This is what we're going to do. We're going to do a little repeat. We did an intro, we're going to do a conclusion. I know you don't have a product out yet, but people should still know where to find you because you're awesome. Miss Elaine, I want you to let the audience know where they can find you. And Miss Eddie, I want you to let the audience know what you're doing and how they can find you too.
Okay, so again, my name is Eddie Louise. You'll find me on social media, always at Eddie Louise. So I'm Eddie Louise on Facebook, I'm Eddie Louise on Instagram, I'm Eddie Louise on Twitter. My first novel is Transmigrations, which is Frankenstein meets Quantum Leap, Victorian mad science and time travel.
I'm hooked.
You've got an elevator pitch down hard.
I'm
working on that.
So, Miss Elaine, introduce yourself and how people and what you're working on. Because you wrote a play and you never told me about it. So it's time you actually fess up to how awesome you are.
I pretended like you never did.
Yes.
And how
sad
it was.
Oh, no.
Co-wrote it, but I actually wrote the whole thing.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, and so
I got 100%
of the course.
So tomorrow at 1 o'clock, I'm doing a workshop.
No.
You're not going to be here?
Well, my class is going to be here for 2 o'clock.
Yeah, at 1 o'clock, it's called the Writer's Room. And it's what I've learned in Hollywood about how the producers, like, build television shows.
Oh,
wow, that's cool.
So we're going to start from raw idea, and by the end of our 50 minutes, we'll have a 3-episode television arc with main and supporting characters and basic idea.
I wish
people still took spec scripts, because I would just spend all my days writing spec scripts for Star Trek.
Yeah.
It's all good. No, it'd be fun. So, Miss Stacey.
Yeah.
So, Miss Elaine. Real quick, how can people find you?
Oh, I can find me on Facebook or Twitter, ELAINEEL_79.
Okay, so Miss Stacey.
Yeah.
Introduce yourself, be nice, and then...
When have I ever?
I mean, to yourself.
Oh!
To yourself.
No.
No, nobody has to be nice to Josh.
No.
yeah, I just met you and I already
know.
No, it's fine.
Yeah, so I have a sister, so I roll with it.
Well, I can be found primarily Twitter, Stacey with an EY _M_M.
Mm-hmm.
I'm working on writing a novel. I'm working on transitioning my career into the literary world. So those are my primary quests right now. So if you have job offers, slide into those DMs.
Yes.
Fantastic.
So I'm
Josh.